know. It's so weird. Okay, well, it's daylight outside, so it fucks up the light. Today I'm going to use palettes from my treasure chest to do an eye look, and I'm thinking of, even though the brand is kind of pissed me off. I want to use the palette and give it another chance because I've used this palette before and I was not that impressed, but everyone else is. So, and it's the Menagerie Cosmetics Feral palette, and I'm especially intrigued, you know, the yellow, because I really dug a hole in that one trying to make that work, and the green, but that is packed to, you know, the maximum, so it's really hard to get something out of it. But yeah, we'll see what we will do. I have already put on my base. I just have, you know, eyebrows and lips and that stuff left later on. I should be cleaning here instead of just putting out more stuff. I had to open up my Linda Hallberg sponge today because no brush works on my face anymore. And the other brushes, no, the other sponges I have tried that I have loved before does not work either right now. And it's nothing wrong with the brushes or the sponges, but this is the only one that works. And the other one I had to throw out. So I open up a new one. It's amazing. And I love that you can, you know, do this. But yeah, side note. Now when I look into the palette, I just feel like using other colors, but I really, really, really want those shades to work, so let's give it a second try. And now I'm just taking on some paint pot, and from the beginning I want to do, you know, the eyeshadow first and then the base, but my battery was so low on the phone that I had to charge it, and the phone wouldn't stay in the place when I charge it. So yeah, so I just know that I will get a lot of fallout, so we'll see if I can fix that later. I'm going away in a few hours, I hope. Now I don't remember what the time is, but I'm going away for dinner at my friend's house, and I'm also helping them with they had some economy questions, you know, bank questions about their funds and their savings and so on. So I'm going to help them. So fun when you know stuff like, you know, pensions and savings and funds and market risks and, you know, stocks and loans and mortgage and everything like that. People want your help, but don't come to me for help if you don't have the bank I work for and talk shit about it. And you can do yourself. But my friend has the bank I'm working for, and then it's much easier for me to help. I think I'm going to try to do the eyeshadow first, the yellow first here, kind of like Annette usually does, but she does it much better. But yeah, so let's try. Oh, it's so powdery. Oh, it really. Can you see that? This is as powdery as the one in Subculture. I don't remember how I used this shade the last time. I just remember that I was so disappointed when everyone else seems to make this work really nice. No wonder there's a big hole in it. And now I have put in the shades that they exchanged. Because you know there were two... I don't know, can you see the fallout? Or the kick up? But these two shades are new. There were two other ones in it before. And I have them in the back in a sea palette. But I'm not going to use those two. So I'm not taking it out. Just want a little bit. Because I think I put on the yellow. I really don't remember. But after. And that was much, much harder. So like that. That worked great. And where is... I think that I will take Wisteria. It's the flamingo pink. Also kick up, but not as much. It's like a neon coral pink. That's pretty. It's almost kind of pastel-y, but it's more neon, if you know what I mean. It's kind of a bright shade, but it performs like a neon almost. Oh, I'm so longing for the Blush Tribe palette. It has shipped the neon palette. I'm so excited to see if it's a good neon. I always hope that it is, but I always get disappointed. The only one that kind of is not disappointed is the Melt Stack that I can think of right away. And then there are some other shades here and there. I also am getting the ColourPop singles, but I saw Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner use them. And she was not so impressed with the Lime, and that's the one I was most excited with. So... well, you know, a bright pink is not that hard to find. It's the other colors that are harder. But this was a really good shade so far. Ooh, people are sending messages to me. I will respond later. Oh, there's yellow everywhere. And now I kind of wish that I had that shade, but maybe we can use something from the other palettes. No, wait. Hello. No, I'm not going to use them. But it's those two shades in here. And I wish that they had exchanged the Canis Lupus shade instead of these, because I really like the pinky neutral one. Yeah, so let's take that. These are even more powdery than the certified shades. These are on the, you know, I usually don't mind that there is kick up, not at all, but it goes to a certain level when it gets annoying, when you have to tap off the brush. And the Subculture is that, and it's annoying because you go through the product very fast. And these shades are also, some of them are also that type of annoying. But I rather have that and that they perform than shades that you have to pack on and nothing happens, you know. Just going to smear that out a bit. Is it too crazy to use? Am I going to use the green under the eye? Let's try that. It's so hard to pick up. It's like hard pan already. It's so densely packed. I wish they hadn't done that. Because these two are the prettiest shades in the palette. And I'm not done with the lid, but I just want to see if I can use the green under here. It's kind of an Easter look. Well, it's the Easter is not over, so why not? Today it's Påskdagen, Easter Day. I don't know if you call it something special, but we have Skärtorsdag. That's I always confuse Thursday and Tuesday, but it's Thursday, right? The day before Friday. We call that Torsdag, and on Easter it's called Skärtorsdag, and then we have the Friday, and it's Långfredag, Long Friday, and then we have Easter Eve, if you are, you know, comparing it to Christmas Eve, so it's Påskafton, and then it's Easter Day, Påskdagen, and then it's annandag påsk. I don't know what you call it, if you even call it something, because I think on Christmas you call it Boxing Day, I think. I don't know why. God, I hate this shade. Not the shade, but you know, the pan. But it's, you know, the other Easter Day. Annan dag påsk, second day Easter. Kinda on tomorrow, so we are free tomorrow as well from work. So that's nice. And since I work in, you know, an office, the day before the Friday, the Skärtorsdag, is a shorter day for us. So it's a long, nice weekend. This is really Easter. Really, really. I really want to use that shade, but let's take that instead. Now I'm just going to hack into this shade and loosen it up a bit because this is freaking annoying. You know, you can't get into it. I don't know if yours is the same way, but can you move these? It's so full. All the other ones are, you know, normal. Pressed and shimmers as well, but this one is over and the pan, and you know, you can't get into it. If I really do like this, then I can get something off, but I don't feel like putting my finger in it every time. And it's such a shame because it's pretty, it's such a pretty shade. Oh god, I have yellow everywhere in my this one. Yeah. We'll see how long that lasts, and we can take something out of. Nu busar vi inte i soffan, gumman. Nej, lukti. Oh, I want to cut my hair. That I never have the time to book an appointment. So annoying. Oh, let's put it over there. I just can't stand it. I think I'm going to take the pack leader shade because that's so damn pretty. Ooh. Yeah. Okay, so this is officially an Easter palette, just so you know. This is like a peachy pink duochrome. She must are so hard to get on. They are really pretty, but they... so want to like this palette, but it's not easy to work with. Not using my technique, at least. I have to change it. My technique usually goes with like almost every eyeshadow palette. Then we want yellow. We dig a new hole in the yellow. Let's see how long that will last, because as you may know, if you will watch my videos, then my eyes will tear up, and then the tear will go up and destroy everything, especially if I have a mat in the inner corner. Oh, but maybe we can take the new Fenty highlighter. Paulina said that that's a really pretty inner corner highlight. I want to try that, even though it may not go with this look. So it's this, it's the Fenty Beauty, what a brat, the pink one. I kind of want to use this brush for that, so we have to take off all the yellow. God, I don't know if you can see, but this is so yellow. This will get fallout. Let's take it on both sides. That's pretty. And this is made to be like a highlighter, so it's not that intense as an eyeshadow. You just get the effect. And that I like. See if I can show you when I get closer. God, that's pretty. It's really, really pretty. Thank you, Paulina. Don't know if you can see, but it's really pretty. I will soon try to film with the camera that I bought from Angelica. But I'm a little bit scared of it. So I have it over there on my dresser, or what you're gonna call it, on my Malm. Think. Some more of this. What? Wisteria. I don't have hooded eye per se, but if you watch Angie from 4F Beauty, she's always linked down below, she tells you about, you know, if you can look like this and I can see the whole lid, which I kinda can, then I don't have hooded eyes per se, but I have very deep set eyes, so it, when I do like this, they go so far in, so it's almost like I have hooded eyes, because I can't barely see anything when I relax. If you don't get what I mean, then watch her videos, because she has the same problem, and she shows you what it means in all her tutorials, so just go and watch her. God, now I have fallout. The yellow have migrated. I don't think that I will do more right now. I'm going to do my brows and put on liner and mascara and see how it looks. And lips as well. And yeah. And we'll see how it looks. So I will be back. Oh. Hello, I'm back. I have put on Lime Crime Metallic Liquid Lipstick in Vibe. Oh, it's almost out. It's a mini. Oh, but I love it so much. Oh, it tickles. And I had almost finished my eyeliner, and just when I was going to put over here the little tip, then Gunvald started barking with another dog, so I was like, oh. So I have to try to fix that, and it went so. But yeah. And I put ColourPop eyeliner in the waterline, and this is called Prance, I think. Prance, yes. I have ordered all of the gel eyeliners that ColourPop released now. It's so annoying because I think I ordered Puppy, which is the orange one, and Piggy Bank, which is the purple one, I think, in an order. And then 2 days later, they released like a lot of them, and I wanted to buy the big pack, but I would get duplicates of those two shades. And then it annoyed me because they don't have all the shades in that one. They have 18 shades, I think, and there are only 15 in that one. Yeah, annoyed. Anyway, so I bought all of the colorful shades. I didn't buy all the browns, and I didn't buy the black and the white, but I bought the other ones. So I really hope they're good, Paulina. And I also want to buy these eyeliners, but I have not tried them out that much, so I don't know if I like them or not, and I've heard kind of mixed reviews. So I have Crybaby, this one, the lavender shade, and then I have Prance, which is this blue, and it really went well with the green to match the Easter theme. And I bought this, is it called Zulu? The turquoise one I have ordered as well, so that will be here shortly. And it was so easy to apply, but the question is, how long will it stay there? I usually don't have good experience with pens. They usually fade away, except the Linda Hallberg ones. That's why I'm also excited about the gel liners. God, I used the pink Glam Glow mask yesterday, the one you got with the Becca highlight, to see if I could put in a picture. Why did the post come today? Weird. But yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, and I could still find some here, even though I cleaned it off, I thought. Like that. And now I don't remember what I was going to say, but yeah. So this is the look, Easter look. I really like the look, but I'm mostly impressed by the shade that I have in the crease, which is. Packaging is not boring, of course it's not boring, it's so pretty, but it's broken. But this shade is really good. And then I used the one that used to be in here. I think it used to be on the Wolfling one, the pinky nude one, oh, just on top. And but I locked the damn screen, come on. And then I used the yellow, which has the biggest dent I have in an eyeshadow. I don't know if you can see it, but and it looks good, but it fades so quickly. I can already see it fading. Let's see if I can put some more on. Oh, it click. Ah! Where is that brush? Are you kidding me? Why can't I see the brush? Why did I even put it? Are you joking? Why do I always put this in upside down? Well, never mind. But it fades, and it's not that easy to. Oh, okay, I don't like it. I have to use it more to be really sure, but Oh, not my favorite, and it's so disappointing because everyone else seems to have so good experience with it. And then the green I have under the eyes because that's the easiest way for me to use it because it's so densely packed and it's hard pan and just annoys the crap out of me. But I'm really excited to use these four shades. They look really nice. And I've also used that shade and it was nice, but ooh, you have to go in so many times to get, you know, you get a lot on the brush, but to get it to go off the brush onto the eye, or if you use your finger to get off the finger, it's really hard. It's not that creamy. But the look turned out good, but it's not a palette that you know, use when you're in a hurry, if I say it like that. I have yellow everywhere. But yeah, and then I had, you know, then I put it back, but the Kilowatt highlighter in What a Brat in the inner corner, I really liked. I don't know if you can see it, but it really looks pretty. And I hope it will take if my my eyes start to water up and wander. And by the way, I was in a store, you know, Malmö has a really big mall called Emporia. And there is a store there that is called, it has been called so many things, but it was called Sweet Love Sugar for a while, but now it was called Overhyped, I think. And there is just, you know, geeky stuff. There's a lot of, I think it's American candy, I don't know, but there are jelly beans and different kinds of Pringles and weird sodas and, you know, stuff that we don't have. And then there are a lot of t-shirts like Harry Potter, Pokemon, Fortnite, Game of Thrones stuff, and what's it called? Figurines and everything. So I bought a coffee mug, you know, the one with the rubber lid, from Friends, the TV show Friends, and it's a lot of quotes on it. Don't I have it so I can show it? This is a really long video. So, you know, it's one with, you know, with these types of lids. And if you are a true friend, that was my alarm. But as I was saying, if you are a true friend fan, you will recognize all these quotes. That's my absolute favorite TV show. It's not the one that I like the best right now, but it's my all-time favorite, and I know everything about it. So you just compete with me. As I was so close to buying a Trivial Pursuit game with friends, but I didn't. But yeah, it looks like this. Let's see if I. So if you start there, that's one of my favorite episodes, the Unagi one. We were on a break. This is the longest video just to say what I'm about to say when I showed you this. I wanted this for so long, and they, when I saw it, I was like, yep, thank you. Even though I don't drink coffee. But that was what I was going to say. I bought a really weird soda because I was so thirsty, but I didn't drink it until now. And it's Fanta with pineapple. We don't have that many types of Fanta in Sweden. We have had some on and off, but we don't have just normal pineapple. And I rather drink Fanta than ordinary or regular Coke. So that's why I bought it. Looks like this. It's okay, but you know, it's not a favorite, but really tastes like pineapple. I think that was all. Happy Easter!